Once upon a time, in a quiet land, far, far away, there lived a kingdom where people were constantly in fear. Why was that so? Because there lived an orc who would terrorize folks who came too close to him. As he lived near the king and queen were worried for their people. This caused them to summon a warrior to take care of the beast. Filled with confidence and duty, the warrior promised that she would take care of the orc within a day. With her trusted friend, they went to face the beast. "Grrr," the orc whispered warningly. "You there," the warrior quietly said. "It is my duty to stop you from terrorizing our kingdom." "Hmph," the orc scoffed. The warrior came closer to see the orc as he was hiding in the shadows. When she came closer, the orc displayed signs of shyness rather than intimidation. The warrior was confused, for she wondered if this was the same beast terrorizing the land. "Come out," the warrior demanded softly. The orc shook his head. The warrior sighed and with much resistance eventually took the beast out of his cave. At first, he was covering his face. "Show yourself to me," the warrior whispered insistently. The orc put his hands down slowly. Everything started to make sense. The orc seemed to terrorize everyone and everything because he was embarrassed of the blemishes on his face. The warrior's hardened face softened, for she too understood the pain of consistent blemishes, healing, and scarring. "Just because I'm a warrior doesn't mean I don't understand self-care. Let me help you." The orc, who was reluctant at first, decided to accept the offer. "You're in luck, beast, for I carry my ointments with me." The orc silently stared at the warrior, mildly regretting his life choices. "Don't look at me like that. Believe me, you'll be happy you met me," the warrior boasted quietly. The orc gave the warrior an indifferent look, while the warrior observed the orc's face. "Matter of fact, why don't you let me clean your ears too? It looks like it's been ages since you bothered to clean it." The orc blinked at the bloodlust of the warrior. However, thinking about how he had been living his life, nothing else would hurt at this point. The orc nodded. "Great," the warrior happily whispered. "Let's start with your face," the warrior quietly exclaimed. "I'm going to be applying a cleanser, exfoliating your skin with a scrub that will extract the blemishes and applying a lightweight oil with healing properties for your skin. Oh, and don't worry, I will be putting on gloves to avoid contamination." The orc nodded and closed his eyes. The warrior proudly whispered, "Your skin is glowing and smooth now." One can almost tell that the orc blushed ever so slightly. "Let's take care of your ears now," the warrior stated quietly. The warrior explained quietly, "I'll be using a wooden ear pick so I can scrape off all the earwax you have built up in your ear. Afterwards, I'll use a little cotton ball to clean the inside of your ear as well. Lastly, we'll finish this with an ear massage." The orc grunted softly, accepting all that is to come. "We finished everything now," the warrior whispered. The orc opened his eyes, feeling content. "I need your help with something now," the warrior spoke carefully. The orc blinked and wondered what the warrior would request. "I was hired by the king and queen to take you down. However, seeing how all of this was a misunderstanding, I would advise that we meet them to resolve the issue immediately. That way, both sides can enjoy their life peacefully." The orc nodded, determined to fix this issue once and for all. The newly acquainted team traveled back to the kingdom. The warrior explained the situation, and the king and queen listened with great patience. Everyone came to the agreement that if the orc got along with the people, the kingdom would consider the orc as one of their own. Everyone celebrated, as peace was returned to the kingdom. ASMR saved the day.